city of Ayodhya. And what we'll do is we'll just give you a full 360 degree view of where we are standing right now before we get you all the action. I'll just step aside the frame. This is the famous Tulsi Udyan here. All very well lit up, people there waiting in anticipation. This is essentially based on the legacy of Sant Tulsi Das. You're in Ayodhya, and when you're in Ayodhya, you'll be talking of the Ram Mandir. The Ram Mandir not very far away, but all this crowd, all this sea of supporters and a sea of saffron that you see right now essentially is waiting for the first glimpse of the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister, who's going to be landing in the next few minutes, close to about 6:40, 6:45 is what we are given to understand. And from there, he directly moves to the Ram Mandir. That is just about few meters from here. He's going to be spending about 15 minutes in the Ram Mandir, after which he begins this entire road show. The road show will begin again from the other end from where we are reporting right now. And from here, it's a 2 kilometer long road show that moves on and culminates at the Lata Mangeshkar Chowk. In fact, that is on the other extreme. But what's extremely significant to look at right now is the kind of politics that you see on the entire issue. The Prime Minister, for the very first time, ever since the announcement of the Lok Sabha elections, is coming to Ayodhya. For the very first time since the Pran Pratishtha on the 22nd of January, that the Prime Minister will be here. The opposition says that this is because the entire Ram Mandir issue is not helping the BJP as much as they would have wanted, and the Prime Minister here is landing in Ayodhya and having this roadshow to rekindle those spirits. Now, clearly, there is a lot of politics. What the Prime Minister has said so far on the entire issue is also important. He has said, ki mere liye Ram Mandir koi chunavi mudda nahi hai. He said, this is a matter of my personal faith. Everywhere that you look around, whether it's the right, whether it's the left, whether it's behind me, only and only you will see a sea of a lot of these people. And we'll talk to them also in just a moment, get you more insight from a team of reporters that is tracking the entire story from different ends of the entire city right now, that is all decked up, that is waiting right now for the Prime Minister, someone who said he delivered the promise of the Ram Mandir. But before that, the Prime Minister was in Uttar Pradesh earlier. He was in Itawa, again the stronghold of the Yadavs. And from there, the Prime Minister has yet again spoken of the entire Ram Mandir. He's hit out at the Samajwadi Party. He's hit out also at the Congress. And he has again said ki ye wahi log hai jo Ram ke astitva mein hi sawal khade karte the. So you see that entire assertion by the BJP, including the Prime Minister, that on one side are those people who believe in Lord Ram, who work to ensure that Lord Ram, Ram Lala, has its own mandir here in Ayodhya. And on the other side, like the Prime Minister says, are those who are non-believers. So this, he said, is a battle between those who have faith in Lord Ram versus the non-believers. Clearly, this is another important political pitch that the Prime Minister is preparing. A lot of anticipation in the air. There are, you know, people almost at every end, whether these, you know, are these women. A lot of women also I see in the entire crowd here. A lot of children, a lot of elderly. So everyone that you see here only says that we want to see the Prime Minister. Let's quickly first move on to get you an insight into how the day has spanned. What has the Prime Minister said when it comes to those who believe in Lord Ram versus those who've questioned Lord Ram for the longest time?
कांग्रेस के साहजादे ने तो कोट के ऊपर जनेऊ तक पहन लिया था, लेकिन इस बार मंदिर के दर्शन बंद, कोट के बाहर टंगा जनेऊ उतर गया। इतना ही नहीं, 500 साल बाद एक ऐतिहासिक पल आया, पूरा देश भव्य राम मंदिर बनने से खुश हुआ, लेकिन इन्होंने प्राण प्रतिष्ठा का निमंत्रण भी ठुकरा दिया। साथियों, इनको तो इतनी नफरत है, अभी मैं द्वारिका जी गया था गुजरात में, अब एक कांग्रेस के साहजादे को बड़ी परेशानी है। कि कृष्ण क्यों पूजा करने के लिए नीचे गए क्यों। अब मैं ये यहां के सपा वालों को पूछना चाहता हूं, अरे आप तो अपने आप को यदुवंशी कह रहे हो, श्री कृष्ण के वारिस कह रहे हो, और देश का प्रधानमंत्री श्री कृष्ण की पूजा करे और तुम्हारे अपने साथी उसकी आलोचना करे, अरे तुम काहे को यदुवंशी हो रहे।
So you've just heard the Prime Minister who was speaking earlier in Uttar Pradesh's Itawa. From there is where he's headed now to Ayodhya. And like I said, close to about 6:40, 6:45 is when you will see the Prime Minister landing in Ayodhya. And we have a team of reporters tracking this story from different lengths and breadths of the entire city. In fact, we've also spent the last couple of hours speaking to a lot of people. Anyone that you speak to will speak of the changes the entire city, remember, has seen. This includes development, this includes these roads that are widened right now, this includes a lot of this, renovation that you have seen over the entire city, and also people say, ki ab ki baar 400 paar zarur hoga. Will that happen or not? Listen in quickly to this report that we filed a little earlier. And in the next few hours, the Prime Minister is going to be in the temple city of Ayodhya. A city today that needs no introduction. A city that all devotees want to come towards. A city right now that has this beautiful Ram Mandir that you see behind us in our pictures. A lot of it, remember, is still under construction. By December 2024 is when the entire temple, in fact, is going to be completed. And even as the Prime Minister is expected here shortly, you will see huge crowds of people already waiting for hours for the darshan of the Ram Lalla. Now, clearly, is this a big issue during these Lok Sabha elections? The Prime Minister time and again has said, ki ye koi chunavi mudda nahi hai. Ye chunav ki baat nahi hai. He said, this is a matter of personal faith. Now, when the Prime Minister is going to be here, this is for the very first time since the Pran Pratishtha that the Prime Minister is visiting Ayodhya, and for the very first time since you've had the entire announcement of the Lok Sabha elections. I'll speak to people and find out. Aap kahan se aayi hai? Darshan ho gaye?
Ji.
Kahan se aayi hai?
Nawada se.
Nawada se aayi hai yahan par. Darshan kaise hue?
Bahut acha suga, bahut acha.
Pehli baar aayi thi yahan par?
Pehli baar aayi hai.
Kaisa laga?
Bahut acha laga hai.
Aap amma kahan se aayi ho?
Delhi se.
Aap log Delhi se aaye?
Ji.
पहली बार दर्शन के?
हाँ, पहली बार आए।
कैसी तैयारी है, कैसे इंतजाम?
बहुत ही सब कुछ व्यवस्थित बहुत अच्छा है, नहीं कहीं पे रुकने का कोई प्रॉब्लम है, ठीक साक सब कुछ ठीक साक से है।
और आज प्रधानमंत्री का यहाँ पर रोड शो है, अयोध्या में आएंगे पहली बार?
अभी हम लोग देखने वाले हैं। अभी
इतनी भीड़ है, गर्मी है, धूप है, रश हो रहा है,
फिर भी देखेंगे जी।
इसी रूट से जाएंगे प्रधानमंत्री?
इसी रूट से जाएंगे। अभी हम लोग अभी वही वेट करेंगे उनका।
नो मोदी सरकार।
अच्छा, मोदी सरकार की आप बात करती है, बाकी ऑपोजिशन का क्या है? और कोई नेता नहीं है क्या मोदी जी के टक्कर में?
नहीं है फिलहाल तो, नहीं है फिलहाल, नहीं है।
So you just heard a lot of these people who, in spite of the heat, remember it's still pretty hot when you're reporting, from on the road. And the Prime Minister also again and again has said that it's important that each one of us step out and we cast our ballot. On that note, let's also talk about the big Ayodhya battle. Remember, this is the Faizabad constituency. The sitting MP here is Lallu Singh from the BJP. He's pretty confident. Now, today you will see Lallu Singh along with the Prime Minister when the Prime Minister will be on this entire path. This is also called the Ram Path that leads to the Lata Mangeshkar Chowk on the other side. Lallu Singh was in conversation with our colleague Pragya earlier, and he says that the opposition is agenda-less. The opposition continues to deride the faith of millions of people.
आज अयोध्या प्रभु श्री राम का दर्शन करने आ रहे हैं, और यहीं से वहाँ प्रभु श्री राम लला के मुख्य द्वार से लेकर के लता मंगेशकर चौराहे तक वह रोड शो करेंगे। अयोध्या को सजाने का हम सब पूरा प्रयास कर रहे हैं, और जगह जगह पर सपूज साधु संत वहाँ आशीर्वाद देने का काम करेंगे। मातृशक्ति भी खड़ी रहेगी, उनके रथ के आगे भी मातृशक्ति चलेगी। देखिए, राम मंदिर पर के आधार पर हम राजनीति नहीं करते, वो हमारे श्रद्धा का केंद्र है। विपक्ष के लोग तो कुछ जानते नहीं, जमीन पर तो कोई है नहीं, सब बड़े बड़े घर के लोग हैं, बड़े बड़े घरों के। तो कोठियों में रहते हैं तो उनको क्या मालूम है क्या।
सो लल्लू सिंह देर से इनकी लोग कुछ नहीं जानते ऑपोजिशन वाले क्योंकि वो जमीन पर नहीं है। तो इस दी ऑपोजिशन रियली टू बी फाउंड हियर और नॉट, दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू विल नो ओनली ऑन जून द 4th। डू रिमेंबर अयोध्या इज गोइंग टू बी वोटिंग ओनली ऑन मे द 20th, बट व्हाट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स रोड शो कुड डू इज इंपैक्ट द नेक्स्ट फेज ऑफ पोलिंग दैट हैपेंस ऑन द 3rd, फॉर विच द कैंपेनिंग नाउ हैज ऑलरेडी एंडेड, एंड ऑल्सो अबाउट द 23 सीट्स इन द अवध रीजन दैट डज इंक्लूड अमेठी एंड ऑल्सो द सीट्स ऑफ रायबरेली। Without wasting any time, I quickly want to introduce a panel of guests who've been very patiently waiting. We have Sanju Verma, national spokesperson of the BJP with us. Mr. R. Rajgopalan, who's a senior journalist. Lokesh Jindal is a political analyst. He leans towards the Congress. And also Kapish Srivastavaji, who's the spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party with us. And I'm requesting all our guests to bear with me just for a few minutes. Also because I'm on the ground. A lot of our viewers are wanting to know what is the action at both the ends from where our team is reporting. I have both Pragya and Adeep joining us live. First to you, Pragya. Where about you? At what point are you right now of this entire, you know, sea of people that I see? And what is it, Pragya, that you've gathered in the last few hours?
Well, Deepthi, we are at the main entrance of Ram Temple. Remember, this is the very site where Pran Pratishtha invitees went inside and also came out. This is right across Birla Dharmshala that there is. But, you know, just a few moments ago, we saw Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath also coming here. He was inspecting all the security measures and he was waving to the crowd. Obviously, the atmosphere is very electrifying. Everyone has gathered here, refusing to go despite the police saying that you need to keep a distance. They all want to have that one, you know, glance at Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and this is exactly what they are waiting for. There are cultural activities right across the platform. There is a roadshow. Security arrangements are very tight here. Everyone has everything has been cordoned off. But those who are performing cultural activity, they are still waiting. They have been performing for hours, but they are still waiting for Prime Minister to come and see their performance. And this is very, Prime Minister would be filing the nomination on 14th, is what we have gathered. But the fact that he is coming to Ram Temple just ahead of his nomination is also very, very significant. There's a larger message that BJP and Prime Minister is giving through Ayodhya here, which is that Ram Temple has been built after many decades of waiting, and it is under.
Okay, Pragya, apologies, I'm just interrupting you here because we have limited time, and before I come to Adeep, I quickly want to get in a word with all our panel of guests, and then we'll also get you live images that will be coming in from the airport. The Prime Minister, remember, expected to land in the next few minutes. He'll be landing in Ayodhya, directly going to the Ram Mandir, and he'll be, then after he worships Ram Lala, he's going to be headed here for the road show. Before I get in, Sanju and Mr. Rajgopalan, Lokesh Jindal, when you look at these entire images behind us, when you hear people saying ki Congress ne baki kisi party ne Ram Mandir ke liye kuch nahi kiya, it's only because of the Prime Minister today that you have the Ram Mandir, Lokesh. Should you be nervous or you're ready to dismiss this entire sentiment?
Well, if Ram Temple is the solution to all our social and economic problems, if just constructing temples is going to resolve all forms of problem that households face, we will contribute day and night towards building of lots of temples all across the country. But the issue is this declining per capita income, this relative inequality, this relative poverty, this concentration of wealth in the hands of few, rising social tensions, marginalization of certain communities, targeting certain communities on religious lines. These are all setting bad precedents. I myself, I am a devotee of Lord Ram. I am a practicing Hindu. But then I object to politicization of my religion just to secure votes. The religion is not a means.
Okay, so Lokesh, you say you are a believer in Lord Ram. You have a problem with the politics of this. But then, Lokesh, a number of questions will be asked of the Congress party that went temple hopping also. But before we unravel that, let me get in Kapish quickly and then Sanju and Rajgopalanji also. Kapish Srivastavaji, you represent the Samajwadi Party. Now, why is it that leaders like Akhilesh Yadav, leaders like Dimple Yadav have had no time. The entire opposition had had no time to visit the Ram Mandir. The Prime Minister, after the Pran Pratishtha, is coming here. How can you say this is politics?
एक राजनीतिक दल से, एक राजनीतिक व्यक्तित्व से आप नीतियों की बात कर सकते हैं। आस्था और धर्म की बात ये व्यक्तिगत प्रैक्टिस की विषय है और हम सारे लोग पूजा अर्चना करते हैं, चाहे अखिलेश यादव हो या डिंपल यादव। इस देश में नहीं, पूरे विश्व के एक एक व्यक्ति में भगवान श्री राम का वास है, जन जन के अंदर। तो आप उन्हें एक जगह पे ही क्यों देखना चाहती, क्यों उनका राजनीतिकरण करना चाहती? राम राज्य की जो कल्पना है वो दैविक दैविक भौतिक तापा, राम राज्य में काहू नहीं व्यापा। क्या आपको लगता है कि इस देश से बेरोजगारी खत्म हो गई? क्या आपको लगता है इस देश से महंगाई खत्म हो गई? क्या आपको लगता है कि प्रज्वल रमन्ना जैसे व्यभाचारी इस देश से समाप्त हो गए, सेंगर जैसे व्यभाचारी इस देश से समाप्त हो गए, जो राम राज्य को कलंकित करने का काम कर रहे हैं और प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया उनके लिए हाथ जोड़ करके वोट मांगने का काम कर रहे हैं? सेंगर जैसे लोग,
ठीक है कपीर जी, आप भी कुल मिलाकर वही बात कर रहे हैं जो लोकेश कहते हैं कि महंगाई की बात करिए, बेरोजगारी की बात करिए, बट ऐसे में क्या आप राम मंदिर का सच झुठला सकते हैं? लोकेश जी और कपीश जी, आप दोनों से ये सवाल पूछा जाएगा। आई वांट टू गेट इन संजू क्विकली एंड देन मिस्टर राजगोपालन हियर। संजू, इज देयर मेरिट इन व्हाट द ऑपोजिशन क्लेम्स दैट बिकॉज यू नो द बीजेपी रियलाइज दैट द राम मंदिर इशू इज नॉट गिविंग देम डिविडेंड्स, सो हियर इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ट्राइंग टू पुश दैट एंटायर नैरेटिव। यू वांट टू यूटिलाइज राम मंदिर राइट इन द मिडल ऑफ इलेक्शंस एंड दैट इज व्हाई संजू द ऑपोजिशन सेज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इज फोर्स्ड टू कम टू अयोध्या।
You know, Deepthi, first and foremost, you're looking great in that traditional outfit. Coming to the more serious issue at hand, let me just make a couple of points. Point number one, the Ram Mandir temple issue was first introduced in the Palanpur resolution of the BJP way back in 1989. And since 1989, in almost every BJP manifesto, humne kaha tha, mandir wahi banayenge. And look at the beauty of this entire thing. Na keval mandir vaha ban raha hai, par Prabhu Ram ki pran pratishtha bhi January 22, 2024 ko bade harsho ullas se ho gayi. Aur Congress ke pet mein marod uth rahe hain, Congress ke pet mein ubal uth raha hai. This is the same Congress party which went to the Supreme Court saying Prabhu Ram to hai hi nahi. This is merely a figment of BJP's wild imagination. Then you had Mallikarjun Kharge on the eve of 2019 election said, "Is baar Modi ko mat jitaiye, kyunki yadi Modi jeet jayenge, to this will become a Hindu country." To inko Prabhu Ram se itni nafrat kyun hai? Haal filhaal mein, kuch hi ghante pehle, Congress ki rashtriya pravakta Radhika Khera has said she was locked up in a room, she was manhandled, she was misbehaved with. Only because she dared to visit the Ram Temple at Ayodhya. यही बात कांग्रेस के प्रवक्ता गौरव वल्लभ ने भी कहा, यही बात कांग्रेस के प्रवक्ता रोहन गुप्ता ने भी कहा। Why this visceral hatred for Prabhu Ram? Why this visceral hatred for Ram Bhakts? Okay. Why this visceral hatred for Narendra Modi?
Sanju is putting out a valid question for both Lokesh and Kapish to respond to. Why this visceral hatred for Lord Ram? I just have enough time to get Mr. Rajgopalan quickly for 30 seconds before we hit our first break. Mr. Rajgopalan, sir, how do you view the entire, you know, discourse of the Ram Mandir now at the end of the second phase before the third phase? How do you think this could affect the polling that is left, not just in Uttar Pradesh, but the rest of the country, sir, now?
Vithi, Mr. Narendra Modi, Prime Minister of India in Ayodhya means it will have an impact in Bihar. It will have an impact in Jharkhand, it will have an impact in Uttar Pradesh. Therefore, all the three states which will give 150 seats to BJP, it is going to be a bump up. Second thing, Sanju Verma was telling about Radhika Khera. This Radhika Khera thing is, you know, she was locked inside. A call came from some 24 Akbar Road and they were smashing her for her visiting Ram Mandir. These are all certain issues which Congress should bear up. And Lokesh Jindal, I am very shocked. After June, July, Lokesh Jindal will also follow other spokespersons to join BJP.
Mr. Rajgopalan, you know, you know, Lokesh, I think on a serious note, this is a lot of soul searching that Congress needs to do with it. That is, there a lot of disconnect between what the party thinks in their own office and what the Janta thinks. You know, in Ayodhya, you can actually feel the energy, you can feel the color, you can feel that connection. What we'll do is we'll say thank you only for the moment to all our guests, Sanju and all gentlemen, right now.